How possible is it that as good and as much praise as Malkin gets, that maybe he's a little underappreciated? Maybe we're not giving him enough praise.
I think he is. I mean, he's the Robin to Sidney Crosby's Batman, and rightfully so at times. But this guy's a beast. I mean, a competitor. We always talk about his skill level. We know how good he is, Butchie. But with his shot and his playmaking ability and being able to take a game over single-handedly and the great one-timer, as we just saw there. But
is that the element of his game that surprises you? His over physicality,
the years, and physicality game. He's a gamer. This is a guy that's a superstar in the National Hockey League with a fourth-liner grinder mentality. That's a nice combination.
It really is.
This guy is an absolute monster. He takes backseat to no one physically, certainly from a skill perspective, and he has a scrap in game one. Do you want Evgeni Malkin scrapping for your team? Possibility of injuring a finger? He's so engaged in the hockey game.
Yeah.
Your team, the game's already decided.
Yeah,
they're up 4-1, and he still gets involved with PK Subban. You got to love the guy. And he is absolutely, there should be an investigation. He's a top 100 player. Can't believe he wasn't named. I had to throw that in there.
Maybe a little early. Maybe a little early in his career, but certainly he's a former Conn Smythe winner, and maybe he's going to be a two-time winner, certainly, if they continue to go. But I just love the way this guy competes. I love the way he wants to be a difference maker. He's not a guy that sits on the outside and says, you know, here, give me the puck, and then I'll make something happen. He goes in, he gets it. He's in the corners. He's battling. He's fearless, and that's a part of his game that's matured over his career. He wasn't always like that. He wasn't always consistent. He always wasn't as strong. But now, as you mentioned, Kenny, this guy's a beast with tremendous skill. He can score. We always known that. He's a former MVP. He's an Art Ross Trophy winner. So he's really capable of giving you a whole lot. And he doesn't take a back seat to anybody. He doesn't say, hey, I'm playing with Sidney Crosby, I got to be second fiddle. No, no. He says, maybe I should be the first fiddle.
Yeah.
And the way he's playing in this series, boy, oh boy.
And he's a little old school from your day, like Bobby Orr, from a standpoint that he fights his own battles. He's not asking somebody to step in because I'm a superstar, I'm untouchable. No, I'll take care of myself. I respect that.
If you guys were on the bench and you're watching his little tussle with P.K. Subban, what's going through your mind?
Well, I liked it from a standpoint. Two star players, emotionally engaged here. But, yeah, I'm worried if I'm Coach Mike Sullivan, and for that matter, Peter Laviolette and P.K. Subban, who's a pretty physical player himself. Don't get injured, guys. But this just shows me what's at stake, how important it is to these two guys, not known for this kind of thing too often, the fisticuffs. But that shows they're both so engaged, and they want to win badly.
And you mentioned earlier on, I mean, when your emotions are running that high and you're so involved in the game that you're going to maybe do things that you wouldn't normally do, and you don't think about it. It's just a reaction. I know from your game, that wouldn't take much for you to get going in that direction. From my game, I'd be a little more conservative because I'd probably be on the losing end of any of those tussles. But you got to admire both of those guys. They both want to win badly. One guy was on the right end of the scoreboard. The other guy, not so much. So tremendous excitement, tremendous, like I said, drive to be the best you can.
Yeah. I found that just cowering in the corner in the fetal position seems to throw your opponent off. So don't ever forget that.